Hey guys, welcome back. So today we'll be learning about software engineering project. So how do you write your synopsis, modules, ER diagram, DFT diagram? We will discuss all this one by one. So here first we will learn what is synopsis. So synopsis is nothing but you have to just write a 4 to 5 line description about your project. For example, I take online shopping project. So online shopping project. So here what it is, so I'll be storing and managing the details of the shopping, payment, bills and the customer. In modern world, people shop through online. Decade ago, people had no other choice but to purchase from shop as it is time consuming and it is used to reduce manual work. So you have to just write a 4 to 5 line description about your project. So in short, what is synopsis? Synopsis is nothing but the scope and the objective of your project. So now let's learn what is modules. So modules are nothing but the area of functionality in your project. Now what is this functionality? So example, you have a shopping website. So here you will be having a register form. So this register forms, it takes all the details of the user and stored in the database. So here you can see there is a functionality. So modules will have two types, that is customer module and admin module. So in customer, you can have register page and then you'll be having the checkout page. And then if you want, you can add feedback page. So all this will have a functionality in your project because all this goes and gets stored in your database. And in admin side, admin will be adding the categories. Then he or she will add the product. And if they want, they can view the registered people and the billing and the feedback. So this is the functionality in your project. So in modules, you have to write customer side and admin side. And in customer, you have registration page. So here you have to just give a one line description like, now this module will help the customer to register by providing their details. So for example, in checkout page, this module will help for the confirmation of the product which is placed by the customer. Feedback page is nothing but it gives opinion of the users. So this is how you have to add for admin also, just a one line description. Now let's move to ER diagram. So ER diagram is nothing but entity relationship diagram. So in this you have four basic symbols. So let's see. One is rectangle. This is nothing but your entity which will store in the database. So here you have register page, checkout page. So all these are nothing but entities. And then you have a decision symbol. This decision symbol is nothing but it will relate to entities. And then you have connecting arrows, so any direction it can move on. And then you have an oval symbol. So this is nothing but attribute symbol. So here attribute is nothing but when you have an entity, you have to have the attribute for that entity. For example, name, ID, email, password, like that. So that is ER diagram. Now coming on to DFD diagram. DFD is nothing but data flow diagram. So this is nothing but data flow diagram. So this means that how your project flows. For example, I'll just write here. In my online shopping, first I have a register page and then I have a login. So after login, I will view the category and then the products. And then I can add that into the cart. If you want, you can keep this optional. And after cart, I'll be checking out. And then if I wish, I can give feedback. So this is nothing but your data flow diagram, how your project process. Now let's learn how to make ER diagram. So here we'll make an ER diagram for online shopping. So first I have a register entity. Now here I have register. And what are the attributes? I can keep ID, name, phone number, email, password, etc. Now I have to give a connecting line with the decision symbol to another entity, that is category. So now this register and this entity should have a unique keyword to link both of this. So you can tell that register allows you to go into the category. Allows. Now category you have. Now for category I can give ID, name, description, and then image. So now here you will see category, and then it allows you for product. So after category you will view the product, views the product or view the product. For example, in category I have a pets, that is dog, cat. So these are nothing but category. Now inside category I'll be having different kinds of products. So that is dog. Now inside this dog I'll have different types of products, that is German Shepherd, Huskies, etc. So in that way, so here product, I'll have the ID, product ID, which product it is, and then I can give the name, description, image, price, etc., whatever you wanted. And then finally moving on with checkout page. So here checkout. So in this also I'll have an ID, and then you can tell as address, pin code, state, city, etc., whatever you wanted to add in your checkout page. So here after viewing the product you will order and checkout. So here order. Now in this all of your IDs are nothing but primary key, so just underline it. Now we have to give relationship, like one to many, many to many. So one, I forgotten here to add the feedback. So if you want, you can add over here feedback, or after checking out, you can add a feedback. So in this, I'll have an ID and the name and description. So here gives. So here the registered customer only will give the feedback. So let's have from the register table, not from the checkout. Not from the checkout. So here now let's add the relationship. So one customer can view n number of categories and can purchase n number of products. But after purchasing n number of products, it will check out only with one billing form. And one registered user can give n number of feedbacks. So this is how you relate. Now let's make the diagram for DFD. So DFD are of different levels. So you can tell level 0, level 1, level 2. So in this video we'll be learning with 0 level and 1 level. So 0 level is very simple. You have a customer side and the admin side. Customer, and this is nothing but a process symbol, you know, 1.0. So this is process symbol. Now you have a two arrows from your customer side and two arrows from the admin side. Now here the customer will register to the project. So here is nothing but your project name. So here he'll register, and then in return it gets response. So response. And the admin will log in, and then the admin will retrieve information from the project. Retrieve information. Now before going with level 1, let me tell you the basic symbols in DFD diagram. So the basic symbols are the entity, what you have, the rectangle symbol, and this is your process symbol. Okay, and in this you have to give the numberings, and then process symbol can also be a circle. And then you have a data store, that is nothing but your database. And then you have a connecting lines. So this is the basic symbol in DFD diagram. So let's learn how to, so let's start how to make our level 1 DFD diagram. So first I have a customer side. Now first the customer will register. And then after registering you have a login form. So you make a login form. This is the register process. Now here if he is a new customer, the customer will register and then proceed to login and then move on to view the category. See a category, and then when he registered, the register details will get stored in the database. So I'll make a database register over here. So this is my first database. Now what it happens, it gets stored in this database. So after login it moves on to category. Now this category it will fetch from the database. So it will fetch the images or the details of the whatever you are selling on your website, and then it products, views the products. So this also gets fetched from the database. So I have a product database, and then after product I have checkout page. Checkout. So here the checkout details will get stored in the database. So here it is fetches, and then D4 I have the checkout page or the billing. So here it will get stored in the database. Now here guys, if I have already registered, then I will directly log in. So it is the existing customer. Now if you want, you can add admin or DFD level along with this, or you can make a separate DFD. So I would like to make a separate DFD. So let's make for admin. So this is admin. So what will admin do? Admin will log in. Add the category. Add category. And then next, add the product. Product. And then if he wants, he can view the details of how many people have registered. So let's say like report generation. So here you have a database. So this is your database second, which is the category database, and here you have the product database, and then here you can fetch the details of the registered user and the checkout page if you want to view it. So here you have the registered database and the billing database or the checkout database. So he'll generate it. Generate, and here it will store. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.